the strategic look at some of the equity markets and what investors should be doing. Joining us is Professor David Costa, Dean at Robert Kennedy College. Now, David says there's good value to be found in small and mid caps, with banks and financial services also at bargain prices. Professor, are you there? Hello, David. Nice to see you.
Yes, I'm here. Thank you.
Okay. Now, I'm interested in this. Financials and banks look a worth in the bargain sector. Are you really ready to start picking up financial bargains?
Yes, I think, well, if you look at my back, you will see that today it's everything red here, the Swiss Stock Exchange, which means in a way also there is still a lot of potential to buy and pick up bargains. In terms of financial sector, we have seen some losses this year, but we also have seen incredible growth on the private banking space, because there is a lot of movement now toward managing wealth more than the traditional banking system, and there are few of the private banks in Switzerland which have been giving tremendous return even in a year like that. We're talking about 30-40%. So yes, I do see like buying now some of the bargains, including, for example, some of the cantonal banks, or really something that is more into the private banking field, and therefore the potential of getting great returns on 2008.
Okay, it's interesting. Are you positive on the mid caps? I mean, are you looking to go lower down the scale than the blue chips?
Yes, yes. I'm definitely convinced about that, because if we just now is really a great opportunity to look at the market and see who are the survivors, who are those shares which didn't disappoint us even this year. And there you see a lot of good surprise on the mid cap, and a lot of bad surprise on the, you know, on the index, which have been losing all the things you see on the index here, particularly in Switzerland. So I see a lot of potential in this space, a lot of possibilities. If we look at you know, returns on investment funds, the funds which have been returning, you know, performing the best this year, one concentrated on small and mid-capital companies.
What do you do with emerging markets, David?
Emerging markets, I think, are still very, very interesting. We cannot deny that this year the winners are emerging markets like China and India. I mean, if we just look at the statistics, emerging markets have been doing pretty well this year. However, what I would like to think in terms is we have to look at the emerging market not as a trend, as a strategy. So if you go into emerging markets, you need to be ready to stay there for a long while, particularly markets like India or China, which by definition can be volatile because they are emerging. So I don't believe very much on saying, oh, let me buy some shares in India or some share in China because it's a trend. I believe on buying shares there if you are convinced that strategically it makes sense. And this is also partially what's happening with the big losses on the subprime mortgage. There have been this great trend on buying structured financial products where you didn't know what was inside, and everyone followed the trend, and now big losses. But if you go to emerging market to stay, it's good to do it. But just as an entry and exit, there are a lot of opportunities back home which you can also consider. So it's not just emerging market which will give you big returns. So I see too many people going to emerging markets to get big returns and not as a strategy.
We've seen wheat, up at sort of all-time highs. Are you going to play agriculture still in 2008? And if so, how do you do it?
Yes, I mean, agriculture, I'm still very bullish on agriculture. The best way to do it, in my opinion, is probably to go into specialized funds and more than picking yourself shares. If you're not convinced, I mean, just go for funds, professionally managed funds, which can give you good returns. But again, agriculture is not something which can happen immediately. You need to give it a bit of time. And another important sector, again, as I said before, infrastructure, but also infrastructure in emerging countries. So I forgot to say that if we're talking about India, I would see a lot of potential there on the infrastructure in India. And agriculture, I would say the best way to go into agriculture and infrastructure to a fund.
Okay, David, thanks for that. Professor David Costa, Dean at the Robert Kennedy College, joining us from Zoom.